Hey, welcome back to the Big Dawg acoustic guitar series. This is your very first 30-second chord challenge, and in this one you're going to be changing back an E minor and an A minor. The goal is to be at least 15 changes in 30 seconds. Now that's where you need to be. To move on to the next one, you really need to be able to change 15 changes in that 30-second period. Now, if you're able to do that pretty easily, I'm going to challenge you for something else, because here's the deal. The reason that we're doing this is not just to see how fast you change chords. That's really not it. The whole key is that muscle memory, being able to get those chords into play so that when we do those little riffs, we can form those chords quickly. So here's what I want you to do. Not only do I want you to do the regular formation, which I'm going to put the chord diagrams up there for you, and this is the count that you want to be able to do, the regular E minor, regular A minor. Those are the ones that I want you to hit 15 times in 30 seconds. But to develop your fingers and develop muscle memory, another skill that I want you to try is to use different fingers for the E minor. And here's what you'll do. You'll use your ring finger and your pinky to form an E minor, regular A minor. So you'd go, okay. Then I want you to come back and I want you to use your ring finger and your middle finger for the E minor, regular A minor, okay? And then I want you to use your index finger to pick both of those strings up. I think you can see that. Just use that index finger. Now the key is that you're able to form those chords to where you're not getting a muted sound on that first string. So get your count, and let me show you the count that I want you to use when you're doing your chord changes is like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. That would give you about, if you were able to change a chord each time that you did a count, it'd be 1 per second. I don't want you to have to be that fast. Just 15, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. That's how you want to do it. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and you want to be able to get 15 of those, okay? That's going to be critical. The other skill set, I'm not really too concerned how fast you can do those. What I want you to do is to be able to play them with that E minor and get a nice clean sound. And here's a good way for you to remember how to change it, okay? And it's all that muscle memory, and you think about it in your mind. Remember, we see things visually. So I want you to use your two fingers, pinky and ring finger, and go to that A minor. Then when you come back, you're just changing to the middle ones. And then you come back the third time, and it's just the one. Okay, now I'm trying to hold my guitar up and also everything's in there, but you can do that. It would be one. And make sure you're getting that nice clean sound out of that E minor, okay? Again, your count, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. And I'll have a counter on the screen for you to use. And make sure that you can get 15 before you move on. I want you to be able to make those 15 changes before you move on to the next lesson. How fast you do those other chords, I'm really not concerned about that, but it is a skill that you're going to want to practice. It'll really help you moving on, being able to change fingers for riffs and all that as we progress through the lesson. And then you go ahead and practice that. Get your 15 in 30 seconds, 15 in 30, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, so I'll go ahead and play along with you. Sometimes it's easier to have somebody playing in the background. You can kind of try and mimic that. But if you don't want to hear it, just turn your volume down and you'll have your counter on the screen. And we'll do this at a pace of 15 for 30 seconds, 15 and 30. And we'll do it with a countdown. I'll give you a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 count, and then we'll start. And we'll start on the E minor. So get your fingers in place and we'll start the countdown. And 5 and 4 and 3 and 2 and 1 and 1 and 2 and